People usually hire us because we can provide services from the very beginning of a project, concept designing, even site location, to the very end, interior design and staging, as you will see in this home. So they do hire us for our design, but I also think that they hire us because I'm very direct with regards to the process, the costs. I work very hard to protect my clients in this journey, and I work really well collaboratively with my clients. I'm very fast, and I think that we deliver. I don't think we ever come at any project with the same ideas. We are open to developing any style of architecture, any emotional feeling within a space. But the reality is we go from mountains to fields to water. Most of our properties are view properties, so we're really oriented on whether it's 360-degree view or direct view. I am Cathy Purple Cherry, based out of Annapolis, Maryland. We are in Centerville, Maryland, which is known as the Eastern Shore of Maryland. This was a vision and a dream of our client, specifically while there is a husband and a wife. The husbands had dreamed of this for probably the last 25 years. He always wanted a Maryland-style generational compound that would support his family and his friends for a long time. So this project consists of 9 structures that are relatively closely located so that they're walkable. This client specifically knew a lot about the architectural style of what he wanted. That was actually terrific. He knew that he wanted a large Georgian-style Maryland country home. He knew that he wanted painted brick. He knew that he wanted the out structures that are on the property. But at the same time, he was very open to allowing input, modification, changes, layering, heavy millwork, creative opportunities. And I think that's what allowed us as an office to really provide such a special design. The kitchen is a house unto itself. It consists of a big island with the whole kitchen prep area. It has a 6-foot-long custom-made stainless steel sink and 3 faucets. Love it. Next to it has the second island, but the island isn't actually a seating island. It's more like a piece of furniture, again, custom designed, has a zinc top and is painted a different color in a coastal blue. Next to that is a third island table that is a slab of wood that was built and designed into a table with these industrial legs. And then beyond that is a casual sitting area against a fireplace. It is actually very functionally designed. There is a bar area, there is a coffee station area, there is the working components of the kitchen. Connected to that kitchen actually is a butler's pantry with great, fun, playful gray on gray brick flooring and stainless steel elements, open glass refrigerator. And that element supports the kitchen, but also connects through to the formal dining room. The formal dining room, this house is large enough that it wanted a formal dining room. This is a 28,000 square foot home. And you can see all the way through the house. So it's connected, but it's formalized by the molding and the millwork that surrounds that space. The whole conversation was, does it take a formal dining table or does it take a casual dining table? Ultimately, the casual dining table won. This particular client also had a 25-year history of collecting magnificent artwork because, again, it's a feature that makes a house feel like it's truly a home. We're standing in the library, which is immediately off of all of the public spaces. This is what I call a double-layered millworked room. We asked the client if we could actually do kind of this effort of creating special little moments throughout this room, which we did, obviously starting with the idea of the two little built-in benches with leather seats that flank the fireplace that led to the built-in bookcases both sides. On the end of the home that consists of the billiards table and the bar is also the property owner's office. And it is a monochromatic room. What a monochromatic room means is that the room is one color. And frequently these one color rooms tend to sway into the darker color. So it's kind of a dark slate blue. And it incorporates warm browns in the leather and in the flooring and brass in the light fixtures. The most exciting part of this room is something that I'm getting ready to show you. It happens frequently. Sometimes these hidden doors actually go into a more functional space. That way you can hide your printer and copiers. In this particular case, this hidden panel goes into a space in which a safe is currently sitting. This is basically the game end of the house opposite the far end, which contains the kitchen. This is the party room. This billiards room, what I love about doing an intricate room like this, even though you may not recognize it, is every intersection of every piece of millwork and detail is actually designed and drawn. We design these with slate insets so that the drinks can be set on the drink rail itself. The stools came from First Dibs, which is a terrific resource. The ceiling is a curved Doug Fir beadboard ceiling. And let's step down into the bar. So what's so fun about this bar first is obviously the Chicago brick is used again. The horizontal V-groove to give it a more nautical feel and playful feel. One of the elements that is a lot of fun, if you follow me, is that behind the interior wood shutter, we play darts. Isn't that great? The double story volume was created for two reasons, for the drama of the space, but also to integrate it back into the guest suite, which is located above. There are windows that connect that suite into this space. So I asked if we could do a little hidden stair that went down into the wine room. So welcome to the wine dining room. This dining room has been designed with all Chicago brick veneer, cut and mitered on all the groin vaults that you see in the ceiling. This was probably about 8 months of masonry work. The furniture was set up so that it can be combined together to create one long dining area. It was recently used for a wedding in the family, and the client allowed us to introduce this very large circular window and dining banquette area so that smaller groups could come down. Beyond through the circular window, you're actually seeing the conditioned wine cellar itself. So let's move that way. You go into a dark monochromatic built-in room. It is temperature controlled and obviously contains a very large volume of beverage. There is a theater room that's located down in the basement of the home. You always enter from its level floor that's level to the outside at the door, and then you tier a series of wood frame steps that allow you to platform your seating. So obviously there is a large 120-inch screen wall. All of the elements of technology are hidden other than seeing that piece. The walls are fabric acoustically paneled, but we got to select the fabric that was used in those panels, which is great. This is the mudroom of the house. It's located on one end of the home and it connects by an open breezeway to the three-car garage. The space is larger than typical for a mudroom, so we had the great opportunity to actually turn it into a multifunctional room. Your typical built-in cubbies for exactly what you see, the shoes, the coats, the gloves, etc. Small pantry, using actually the old-time steel screening as a different character. There's a small little powder room here with wonderful dog wallpaper. We've also brought into this room a large kind of outside potting flower space. You can see that it stores firewood, but at the same time, it's the opportunity for doing a lot of flowers and plants. We incorporated all kinds of materials and beautiful light fixtures above the window walls, which gives it a completely different character than what you historically think of as a mudroom. In the guest bedroom, which is on the opposite end of the house from the master suite. The starting point for me on this was that the bedroom, obviously the sleeping area, usually takes the most significant view. So this space is the sleeping area, and it connects to the water through the French doors and to an outdoor deck. This is a piece that we picked up at High Point, and I love integrating antique elements. And we're not talking about collector elements, we're talking about affordable antiques with new components. It creates a real wonderful warmth to it. I love the use of interior windows. Interior windows are a way to transfer natural light from the outside to the inner core of the home, and a way to transfer your view from the inner core of the home to the outside. I do a lot of interior windows in my homes. Then when you enter into what I basically call the functional space, this room, the fun thing about this room is it connects to the bar. So if we turn and look, you're gonna see all the timber frame. So thus the reason we use the Doug fir color on the window so that these spaces would be tied together. I asked my client if I could elevate a banquette so that if someone was sitting at the table and working on their laptop, they still have full view of the water, which is what I'm seeing from here as well. And I accomplished that by lifting this piece up. This is the guest bathroom. It is a stunning room, completely and entirely encased in Calcutta marble, which is one of the most expensive marbles that you can actually use. There is no closet in this suite. These are the built-ins that represent the closet, obviously. The mirror is used so that it becomes a dressing room unto itself. And then further, the steel bars are put on the top because this is where you lay your suitcases. So as you step a little further and see the tiny little toilet room, this is where we used a fun wallpaper. Although relative quiet, it's still a beautiful gray on white, and the rain head and wall fixture explode with water. This is a laundry room. Washer and dryer with folding counter above, hanging above that, as well as built-in storage and laundry baskets. Hex wall tile. But I think one of my favorite components of this house is what I'll call the self-serve open closet. As you spin around, what you're gonna see, you're not gonna see a closet door. You're not gonna see an attempt to try to hide this. You're seeing a very well-organized closet that allows all the guests in the house to come and take anything that they need. And should they forget their soap or their shavers or their water or their shampoo, here it is, all readily available to them. So you're in the third floor bunk room. There are two bunk rooms that actually basically match each other. One is the girls' end. You're in the girls' room now. It's turquoise color. The boys' is navy blue. This is a room that sleeps seven people, singles stacked, singles along the top, and obviously a double on the bottom. At each bunk is a controllable switch light. Bunk is not about sleeping, bunk is about a party. And so to have a party, you want to keep a visual connection between the head locations, the sleeping ends of all of those bunks, so that everybody can tell stories. There's lots of whimsical moments from hidden objects that make the home quite unique. The end result of this for my client is the completion of a lifelong dream. This is a gentleman who has worked 25, 28 years very hard to grow a company from what was a local company to an international company, single ownership. And through that entire journey, he dreamed of this compound. How I feel is incredibly proud and honored to be involved and to be given the opportunity to use my creative mind at the highest level.